Yes, so Sushikal students, so we are here with yet another interesting lecture. The lecture is Algebra of Limits. We want to discuss some formulas related to limits, quite interesting. In order to understand, instead of just discussing the formulas, we will just understand the background, what's happening. Let's take a function f of x is equal to xk plus x. Let's try to find out the limit of this function at x is equal to 1 of f of x. So how do we do it? We know that we find left limit and we find right limit, and if both the limits converges, we say that the limit is defined, and though there's a little gap, then we just make a guess that this is the limit. This is how we were doing. The same thing we will do. So we want to find the limit of this function at 1. We will try to, this is the value of x, this is the value of f of x. We'll try to reach 1 from left side and from right side. So that we will try to reach by 0.999. We'll take the value. Then we'll take 0.99, then 0.9. And here, you know, we would take, you know, we will come from positive side. How? We can take 1.001, we can take 1.1, or maybe we can take 1.2, whatever it is, it doesn't matter. So then we see f of x. When we come from left hand side, we are not going to find the value for function at 1. This is, we want to guess this. We want to find this by limits. So when we see 0.999, I will take the values from the book. When we see this as 0.999, so the value is, give me a second please. Yeah, it's 1.997001. It's 1.997001. And when I take x as 0.99, it's 1.9701. 1.9701. When I take x as 0.9, then it is 1.71. 1.71. So you see that 1.7 as the interval is little, we want to find at 1, right? Little bigger, the value of f of x is 0.71. When the interval becomes smaller, it's 1.9701. I can see the f(x) going somewhere positively. So when I take the limit very small, basically I'm trying to make delta t approaches 0. You know that, right? I'm sorry, not delta t, the limit, the interval, this interval. I just got confused with delta t because there we were taking time. So this is delta x, you know. So when I took this, it's becoming 1.997001, right? So obviously I can see nothing strange will happen when I just go to 1, you know, or maybe I go more close to 1, like 0.9999. so the things are getting close to 2. I can just make a rough guess, right? So I can say that possibly limit of f of x approaches 1 from negative side is 1.997. obviously next thing would be 2. Nothing strange happens, right? It will not happen. So if I take from positive side, I have seen when it is 1.2, let me see the value, it's 2.64. The value for f of x, let me write in 2.6. when it is 1.01, it is 1.01 is 2.0301, and this value I don't have. So they have one more value, 1.1 also they have. For 1.1, the value of f of x is 2.31. So I can again make a guess. You see 2.64, as the interval is decreasing, here also the value of f of x is approaching towards a particular definite limit. almost the same value which was achieved from negative side too. You see, 2.64 coming to 2.31, then 2.03. Obviously, I feel here it will be, you know, again less than 2.03, but greater than 1 for sure at 1.001. So when I will go for 1, again, I can well make a very good guess that the values are approaching towards 2. So I can say limit f of x from negative side is equal to limit f of x from the, when x approaches 1, from the positive side, right? Are same, that is 2. Got it. So I can say limit exists, limit f of x when x approaches 1 is equal to 2. I'm not writing negative or positive sign. This means I have confirmed that the limit from negative side and the limit from positive side are converging. They are converging too. So this point is definitely 2 point. Okay. So limit exists. So now this is simple. This we know it already, that how to do it. But the interesting thing is, students, we also know what is limit of x square when x approaches 1. This sum already we have done. We will not do here, or I leave the students, I leave it to the students that again take a negative, you know, negative from the negative side and positive side, take same values, and when you see, when you square them, you will get the value for function. So you would see that this limit of x square, new function, this function is x square plus 6. I'm taking a new function, limit of x square, limit of function x square when x approaches 1 would be equal to, you will get it, this is equal to 1. Similarly, please do it yourself, okay? You'll find this is the answer. And then if you take another function, limit x approaches 1, you see, interesting thing I'm doing, students, if you are observing intuitively what I am doing, I am trying to make this limit same, but the functions are different. Have you observed? Limit of x square, different function, right? X approaches 1 is 1. Then I take a different function, but same limit. Limit of, let's say I take a function x. X, this I have already done. So you see, you know, when you take the value for x little less than 1, so if, even if you take the value of x as 0.99999, x is also 0.99999. So when you increase x towards 1, value, this also goes towards 1, either from left side or from right side. So I can convince myself that limit of x as x approaches 1 is 1. Okay. Having defined these two functions, and students having defined the limit of this function, I have something interesting to observe, which would prove as a very strong foundation to understand algebra of limits. Oh, that's really great. So I can go ahead and define the first, you know, first formula, first law, whatever it is, whatever you call it, for the limits. Before formulating that formula, I think it should come to your mind yourself. What? See, limit x approaches 1. Okay, student. So limit x approaches 1, this function, that x square plus x, I've already seen this is equal to 2. I've already just done it. See, limit x approaches 1, x square plus x, this function f of x is equal to 2. I got it just now, right? Okay, so at the same time, I have that, I've just now find limit of x square, x approaches 1. See, same limits I'm taking, but different function is equal to 1. And this one, limit x approaches 1, x is also equal to 1. Okay. So if I join them, if I join these two, I get limit x approaches 1 of x cube. Let's say this is first. Let's say this is second. Let's assume if I just add 1 and 2, I get limit of x cube as x approaches 1 plus limit of x as x approaches 1 is equal to, right side is 1 plus 1. This is equal to 2. But then I've just seen that this is also equal to limit x approaches 1, what? X square plus x. Wow, that sounds very interesting. What does that mean? That means limit of a function at a particular, at when x approaches 1 or something else, maybe x approaches a, I can say. And then limit of another function, when again you see x approaches 1 or let's say a, is equal to limit of, you know, combination of these two. That's something very interesting. X square plus x. Maybe x approaches a. In this case, a was 1. Okay, this prompts me to state a formula. What is that? That formula is limit. Yes, can any student state the formula? I'll be so happy. Limit x approaches a. Let's say we have two functions. One function is f of x plus other function is g of x. You see, in our last case, students, f of x was x square and g of x was x. Is equal to, can any student help me to complete? Limit
x approaches a
f of x
of function f x plus limit x approaches a of function g x.
Thank you very much, Amitoj Singh. That's really good. G of x is really good. You know, teaching students, not really teaching them, but creating background and the students learn themselves. You know, that's the best way of teaching, you know, taking all the pedagogical tools available in the world. The best way, you know, hope I can, God can bless me to teach like this only further. Students, you see, I want to define the second rule, but then it's better that you make an observation again. You see, a function f of x, you know, f of x, you can take x square, you can take this function also, x square plus x, f of x can be anything, right, in terms of x. You see, I can always write like this, this is x into x plus 1, am I right? Now, initially, I use this function to define addition of limits. Now I can use the same function to define what? Product of limits. Okay, now students, let's say I already know limit of this function x square plus x as x approaches 1 is equal to, yes Ishma, I've already done this, limit x square plus x as x approaches 1 is equal to, see, I've already done
limit x squared.
Yeah, limit x square plus x. This is a function. You see, I've done all this. So this limit was equal to 2, right?
2.
Okay. So this is equal to 2. Okay, guys. So I can always write like this also. You see that limit x approaches 1. You see, x square plus x may be written as limit x approaches 1, what? X into what? X plus 1. All right. Now, individually, let me see what is the limit of x approaches 1. You see, the limit should be same. Then only these functions are, then only this algebra is, definable. If x was approaching a, x must be approaching a, x must be approaching a. Also, some functions can be different, no problem. So here functions are different and this is a product. X into x plus 1, limit is approaching 1. So individually, if I say limit x approaches 1, x is equal to, we have already seen this is equal to 1. And also limit x approaches 1, x plus 1 is equal to, so this will be equal to when limit of x is 1, so this will be 2. You can even do it yourself, it will be 2. So you see that, students, very interesting. I'm getting second formula. I can always write it as limit x approaches 1, first function x, then what will come next, students? Plus minus into, any student? Limit of x, x approaches 1. Yes, Amitoj Singh, can you tell me whether I should write plus, minus or into here? Ishma, Arjinder?
Sir, into.
Into.
Exactly right. Okay, that's really great. Limit x approaches 1. X plus 1, and if I really put the values, you see limit of x as x approaches 1 is 1 into limit of x plus 1 as x approaches 1 is 2, that is equal to 2, and this 2 is also equal to limit of xk plus 1 as x approaches 1. This I've already proven. Oh man, that's so that I define a new formula. What is that in product? Limit x approaches a. Suppose I have two functions. Maybe one function is f of x, other function is h of x. So, students, this will be equal to, please help me write. Any student? This would be equal to product of two functions. Limit is same. Would be equal to, come on, limit. Yes, anyone? X approaches a, first function. See, x into x plus 1. I wrote first function here, then second function into. So this will be f of x, then into. Yes, Ishma, can you help me to write down? Limit.
Limit x approaches.
Yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. I've defined two formulas. I've not even defined. I've explained you in the sense that, you know, you can catch them easily, you know. Catch your prey easily. All right. So two functions, two laws, not just stated, students, but, you know, really proven also. So now we go for the next law. What is that? They say, limit x approaches a. So if I have two functions, let's say f of x minus g of x. So this would be, can any student tell? You can always write.
Limit x approaches a of function f of x minus limit x approaches a. Function g of x.
Beautiful. That's really great, Amitoj Singh. Minus limit x approaches a g of. I hope, students, you're writing down, right? It may look very simple, but sometimes I get some confusion. So if you write number of times, it's better. So come on, guys. We have fourth formula also. What is that? We have limit x approaches a. We have tried plus. We have tried subtraction, we have tried multiplication, we're going to try division also. It's applicable for all the four. Oh, that's really great. Limit x approaches a, if you have f of x divided by g of x. So this would be equal to, very simple, this also exists. Limit x approaches a, yes, Ishma? F of x.
Divided by limit x approaches a,
g of x. All right. There's one condition. We have to state a condition here. Can any student tell what should be the condition? But this stuff should not be.
Is not equal to zero.
Not is not. Not is not. Should not be. This step x approaches a, g of x should not be equal to zero. If it is zero, so the whole thing, you know, gets, I don't know, you know, you're not able to define them, you know. So that's all still, you know, not looking too much. But then, yeah, there's something else, students, where you can add a little bit more in product is, students, if you have limit x approaches a, let's say there's a function f of x, and there's a constant lambda. The function is getting multiplied by a constant lambda. You can take lambda.
Excuse me, sir.
Outside, yes, tell me.
Sir, you write mistakenly wrong that gx is not equal to zero.
Oh yeah, it should not be equal to zero. Thank you, Amitot Singh. Thank you very much. Yeah, in other class, there's this other student, Hamza. So he always points out the mistakes I make. I'm thankful to you. It should not be equal to zero. I've said that, written wrong. I'm sorry. So guys, thank you very much once again. Lambda should come out. It's just like, you know, from integration, from differentiation also, you know, we can take them out, constants. They remain unaffected. So constant, this lambda is a constant, remember that. It's not a function of x. Okay, lambda can be taken out. So this will be lambda limit x approaches a, what? F of x. All right, students, I want to give you a homework that I've proven to two limits. I want that you prove, you take any two functions, simple functions, f of x, g of x, and in the comment section of the video only, in the comment section of the video, I would be happy if you, if anyone who's watching this video can take f of x as any function, then take g of x as any function, then take limit for both the functions for anything that also wishes to you. Maybe x approaches 0, x approaches 1, x approaches minus 1, whatever it is. And then prove that this law and this law are valid. Okay. I would be happy to listen to your comments. Students, this is all about algebra of limits. If you like it, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon for our channel, Learn CBSE. We hope to put the videos for all the mathematics, plus 1, plus 2, 9, 10, and physics in this channel. Help us grow, help us reach more people. Thank you very much. Take care.